Oh, जयं स्वात् परमहंस परिप्रागदाचार्य सतन सदसमान भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी भोवाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णविंद की जय। रामाचार्य श्रील हरिदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद की जय। श्री राधा कृष्ण गौर गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरिवर्धन की जय। वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप धाम की जय। तुलसी देवी की जय। भक्ति देवी की जय। स्वामी तो भक्तवृंद की जय। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असेंबल्ड हॉट। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असेंबल्ड हॉट। ऑल ग्लोरी टू द असेंबल्ड गोविंदम आदिपुरुषम तमाहं भजामि।
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 चिंतामणि प्रकर सद्मसु कल्पवृक्षलक्ष्यावृतेषु सुरभिरभिपालयन्तम् लक्ष्मी सहस्रशत संभ्रम सेवमानं गोविंदम आदिपुरुषं तमहं भजामि।
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 Worshipping Govindam, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the original person. So, this sound, Govindam Adipurusham Tamaham Bhajami, is reaching him. He is hearing. You cannot say that he is not hearing. Can you say? No. Especially in the scientific age, when television, radio messages are broadcast, thousands and thousands of miles away, and you can hear. Why Krishna cannot hear your prayer, sincere prayer? How can you say? Nobody can deny it. So, premanjana chirita bhakti vilochane na santasadaiva hridayeshu vilokayanti. Just like thousands and thousands of miles away, he can transfer the television picture or your radio sound. Similarly, if you can prepare yourself, then you can see always Govinda. It is not difficult. This is stated in Brahma Sanghita,
प्रेमान्यन छिड़ित भक्ति विलोचने. सिंपली यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर योर आईज योर माइंड इन दैट वे. हियर इज अ टेलीविजन बॉक्स विद इन योर हार्ट. दिस इज द परफेक्शन ऑफ योगा. इट इज नॉट you have to purchase one machine or television set. It is there. And God is also there. You can see, you can hear, you can talk, provided you have got the machine, you repair it. That's all. The repairing process is Krishna consciousness. Otherwise, everything is supplied, complete, complete set of machine you have got within you. And just like for repairing an expert mechanic required, similarly, you require the help of someone expert. And then you will see that your machine is working. It is not difficult to understand. Nobody can say that it is not possible. In the Shastra, we hear also Sadhu Shastra Guru Bhakra Tinete Kuriya Oikko. Spiritual realization can be perfected by three parallel process. Sadhu. Sadhu means saintly persons who are realized souls. Sadhu. Shastra. Shastra means scriptures, authoritative scriptures, Vedic scriptures, Shastra. Sadhu, Shastra and Guru, spiritual master. Three parallel lines. And if you place your car or vehicle on these three parallel lines, your car will go direct to Krishna. Tinete Koriyaviko. Just like in the railway line, you see two parallel lines, if they are in order, the railway carriages have carried very smoothly to the destination. Here also there are three parallel lines. Sadhu, Shastra, Guru. Saintly person, association of saintly person, acceptance of bona fide spiritual master and faith in the scriptures. That's all. Then your carriage will be going nicely, without any disturbance. Sadhu, Shastra, Guru, Vakka, Tinete, Kuriya, Oikka. So, here, in the Bhagavad Gita, the Supreme Personality of Godhead explaining Himself, Krishna. So, if you say, how can I believe that Krishna said, somebody has written in the name of Krishna, that Krishna said, God said. Now, this is called disciplic succession. You will see in this book, Bhagavad Gita, Krishna, what Krishna said and how Arjuna understood, these things are described there. And the sadhu, saintly person, beginning from Vyasdev Narad down to many acharyas, Ramanuja acharya, Madhya acharya, Vishnu Swami, and latest Lord Chaitanya. In this way, they have accepted. Yes, it is spoken by Krishna. So this is the proof. If saintly persons have accepted, they have not denied. Authorities, they have accepted, yes. This is called sadhu. And because sadhu, saintly persons have accepted, therefore it is scripture. That is the test. Just like it is common sense affair. If the lawyers accept some book, then it is to be understood that this is law. You cannot say that, how can I accept this is law? The evidence is the lawyers are accepting. Medical, if the medical practitioners accept, then that is authoritative medical. Similarly, if saintly persons are accepting Bhagavad Gita as scripture, you cannot deny it. The sadhu shastra, saintly person and scripture, two things. And who is spiritual master? Three parallel nine. Who accept the sadhu and the scripture? Sadhu confirms the scripture and spiritual master accept the scripture. Simple process. So, they are not in disagreement. What is spoken in the scripture is accepted by a saintly person, and what is spoken in the scripture, the spiritual master explains only that thing, that's all. So, via media is the scripture. Just like lawyer, and the litigants, via media is the law book. Similarly, the spiritual master, the scripture, saintly person means who confirms the Vedic injunctions, who accepts. And scripture means what is accepted by the saintly person, and spiritual master means who follows the scripture. So things equal to the same thing are equal to one another. This is axiomatic truth. If you have got $100 and another man has got $100, and if I have got $100, then we are all equal. Similarly, sadhu, shastra, guru, vakya, when these three parallel lines in agreement, then life is success. So here Krishna speaking Bhagavad Gita. Yeah, Maya Saktamana, about the yoga system, he has already concluded in the sixth chapter, the yoga system. And in the first six chapters, it is explained what is the constitutional position of the living entity. There are 18 chapters in the Bhagavad Gita. The first six chapters explains only the constitutional position of the living entity. And when it is understood, just like when you understand your actual position, then your activities actually begin. If you do not know what is your actual position, suppose in office, if your post is not settled up, what duty you have to execute, then you cannot do anything very nicely. Here is a typist, here is a clerk, here is a peon, here is a this and that. So they are executing their work very nicely. So one has to understand what is the constitutional position of the living entity. So that is explained in the first six chapter. Ardena satke na upasakasya jivasya sarupa tat prapti sadhanancha pradhananyam proktam. The Baladev Vidyabhushan has a very nice authorized commentator on the Bhagavad Gita. He says that in the first six chapters, the constitutional position of the living entity has been very nicely explained. And how one can understand his constitutional position, that is also explained. So, the yoga system means to understand his constitutional position. Yoga Indriya Samyama. We are busy with sense activities. The material life means business of sense activities. The whole world activity, when you go, stand on the street, you will see everybody is very busy. The storekeeper is busy, the motor driver is busy, everyone is very busy. So busy that so many accidents in business. Now why they are busy? If you minutely study what is their business, the business is sense gratification. Everyone is busy how to gratify senses. This is material. And yoga means to control the senses, to understand my spiritual position, my constitutional position. Just like a boy who is accustomed to playing only, he cannot concentrate in his study, in understanding his future life, or in elevating himself higher position. Similarly, if we are engaged like child without knowing the future of life, simply playing with the senses, that is called material life. The difference between material life and spiritual life is that if somebody is simply engaged in sense gratification business, that is called material life. And out of many thousands of such materialistic person, if somebody is trying to understand what I am, why I have come here, why I am put into so many miserable condition of life, is there any remedy? These questions when arises, then practically his spiritual life begins. And the human form of life is meant for that. In animal life, they do not know anything except sense gratification. They have no power, their consciousness is not developed. Just like in the Green Lake Park, there are so many ducks. As soon as somebody goes there with some little food, they gather. Kaak, 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 kaak. That's all. And after eating, they are enjoying sex life. That's all. So, similarly, like cats and dogs and these animals, the human life is also like that. If there is no question, what I am, if they are simply directed by the sense urges, they are no better than these ducks and dogs. So therefore, in the first six chapters, it has been decided that a living entity is a spiritual spark. It is very difficult to find out where this spark is, because it is so small, minute. There is no material microscope or machine to find out, but it is there. It is there. The symptom is, because it is there in my body, because it is there in your body, therefore you are moving, you are talking, you are planning, so many things you are doing, simply for that spiritual spark. So, we are very minute spark of the Supreme Spirit. Just like there are in the sun sign, minute particle, shining particle, which shining, these shining particles when they are mixed together, that is sun sign. But they are molecules, they are separate atomic molecules. Similarly, in relationship with God and ourselves, we are also minute particles of God, shining. Shining means we have got the same propensities, thinking, feeling, willing, creating, everything, whatever you see in yourself, that is there in God. So God cannot be impersonal. Because we are all person. I have got so many propensities. That is very minute quantity. The same propensities are there in Krishna or God. But that is very great, unlimited. This is the study of Krishna consciousness. Simply, greatness, my position, is very small. And we are so small, infinitesimal, still we have got so many propensities, so many desires, so many activities, so many brain work. Just imagine how much greater brain work and desire and propensities are there in God. Because He is great. His greatness means all these things what you have got, that is existing in Him, in greatness, that's all. Qualitatively, we are one, but quantitatively, we are different. He is great, we are small. He is infinite, we are infinite. Therefore, the conclusion is, just like infinite particles of fire, sparks, when they are with the fire, they look very nice, with fire and spark. But when the sparks are out of the fire, main fire, they extinguish, no more fire. Similarly, we are sparks of Krishna or God. When we associate with God, then our that illuminating power, fire, is renovated. Otherwise, we are extinguished. Although you are sparks, our present life, this material life, is covered. This spark is covered or extinguished almost. This is only example. It cannot be extinguished. If it is extinguished, how we are manifesting our living condition? It is not extinguished, but it is covered. Just like when fire is covered, you will feel heat on the covering. but you cannot see the fire directly. Similarly, the spiritual spa is covered by this material dress that we cannot see. The doctor says, the bodily function has failed, therefore heart has failed, he is dead. But why heart fails, he does not know. There is no medical science calculated. They will say so many reasons that because the blood corpuscles, red corpuscles has ceased to function, it has become white, therefore it is... No, this is not right answer. The blood can be made red. Our redness is not light. There are many natural products which is red by nature. That does not mean there is light. So this argument that red corpuscles have ceased, therefore life has ceased. No. There are so many arguments and counter-arguments. Actually, this is the fact, because we are speaking on the strength of scripture, saintly persons and spiritual powers. That is the way of understanding. You cannot manufacture with your teeny brain imperfect senses. Human beings, they are imperfect, always. Just for example, that a child is seeing the sun and a scientist is seeing the sun. By nature, the child, the knowledge of the sun is imperfect. The same child, when he takes an instruction from a scientist, he can understand the sun is so great. Therefore, direct perception of knowledge by your these senses is always imperfect. You have to approach authority in every sphere of life. Similarly, if you want to understand what is God, then you have to take shelter of this Bhagavad Gita. There is no alternative. You cannot speculate. God may be like this, God may be like that, there is no God, God is dead, God is not dead. This is simply speculation. Here Krishna says, Maya saptamana prartha yogam junjan madasaya asang sang samagram mang jatha ghasasi tachin. If you believe that Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, is speaking personally, as Arjuna believed, then you can understand what is God. Otherwise it is not possible. Asamsam. So the process is, and the first process is Maya Saptamana. You have to constantly engage your mind in Krishna. That is the yoga process, which we are presenting as Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness, just like if you constantly join yourself with the electric power house, there is incessant supply of electric energy. Similarly, if you constantly engage your mind in Krishna, that is also not very difficult. Krishna is all attractive. Krishna is beautiful. Krishna has so many activities. The whole Vedic literature is full of Krishna's activities. This Bhagavad Gita is full of Krishna's activities. Simply by understanding that God is great, that is neutral state of understanding, but you have to elevate more and more. How great he is! How great he is, it is not possible to understand, because our senses are always imperfect. But as far as possible, you can hear about the activities of God, about the position of God, and you can think over it, you can make your judgment, you can put your argument, then you will understand without any doubt what is God. The first beginning is Maya Sapta Mana. In the last chapter, Krishna has explained that one who is constantly absorbed in the thought of Krishna, he is first-class yogi. First-class yogi. In your country, yoga system is very popular, but you do not know who is a first-class yogi. The first-class yogi explained in the Bhagavad Gita, yoginam api sarvesam madgata antaratma. That out of many, many thousands of yogi, the yogi or bhakti yogi, who is always seeing within himself, within his heart, the form of Krishna, he is first class. He is first class. So you have to continue that first-class yoga system. And that is explained here, Maya Saptamana. Being attached, mind is the vehicle for being attached. If you are attached to somebody, some boy, some girl, some person, generally we become attached to a person. Impersonal attachment is bogus thing. If you want to be attached, that attachment must be personal. Is it not a fact? Impersonal attachment. You cannot love the sky, but you can love the sun. You can love the moon. You can love the stars, because they are localized persons. And if you want to love the sky, it is very difficult for you. You have to come again to this sun. So, yoga system culminating in its perfection, in love. So you have to love somebody, person, that is Krishna. Just like here is a picture, Radharani is loving Krishna and offering his flowers to Krishna, and Krishna is playing with his flute. You can think of this picture nicely, always. Then you become constantly in yoga, samadhi. Why impersonal? Why is something void? Void cannot be. If you think something white, there will be something light, something colorful, so many things you will find. But that is also form. How you can avoid form? That is not possible. Therefore, why don't you concentrate your mind to the real form? Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha. The Supreme Personality of Godhead. The controller, the supreme controller, who has got a body. How? Vigraha. Vigraha means body. And what sort of body? Satchidananda, eternal body. Full of bliss, full of knowledge. That body. Not like body, like this. This body is full of ignorance, full of miseries. And not eternal. Just opposite. His body is eternal. My body is not eternal. His body is full of bliss. My body is full of miseries. Always something troubling me. Headache, toothache, this ache, that ache. Somebody has given me personal trouble. So many adhyatik, adhibhautik, severe heat, severe cold, so many things. This body is always under threefold miseries, this material body. So, if you think of Krishna, that is the process, Krishna consciousness, then mayasakta manaprata jung jinjan madas. If you practice this yoga system, Krishna consciousness, how? Madasraya. Madasraya means taking shelter of somebody who is in touch with me. Madasraya. Madasraya means directly in touch with him, directly you are in touch with him as soon as you think of him, his form. But unless you take shelter of a spiritual master who knows about him, you cannot concentrate for a long time. It may be temporary. Therefore, you have to hear from a person who knows about Krishna, then your concentration of mind on Krishna will continue. You have to act according to his direction. Everything, your life should be molded in such a way under the direction of the spiritual master. Then you can continue this yoga system perfectly. What is that yoga system? That yoga system explained in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 6th chapter, last verse, yoginam api sarvisam madgata antaratmana. One who is always thinking of me, Madhugata. He is first-class yogi. In many places it is stated,